amid summits in Ukemanical and Bureau Mutare residents have called on government to extend the ongoing biometric voter registration BVR exercise owing to the low turnout experienced in several areas. Speaking during a consultative public hearing on the Electoral Amendment Bill and the Insolvency Bill by the Parliamentary Portfolio Committee for Justice, Legal and Parliamentary Affairs on Tuesday, participants expressed concern that many residents might not be able to register before the deadline of December 19, a representative from the Zimbabwe Election Support Network session MS Gertrude Kimanikira said government should do away with the challenges that had been associated with the voters' roll in the past and allow more time for voters to register. Historically there have been challenges with the voters' roll, she said. We would wish that the ongoing voter registration process should enable all those who qualify as provided for in the Constitution of Zimbabwe to register without hindrances. We wish that the process of BVR may be extended beyond previously scheduled dates in view of the fact that we have observed low turnout in several areas, Ms. Akhimanikira said government should publicize the last pass and an extension of BVR through bulk messages and other forms of electronic media to ensure all voters are aware of the dates. The final voters' roll should be subjected to audit to ensure that it meets the key principles of voter registration and the elements of a good voters' roll, she said. Mr. James Mundenda, Director of Governance and National Constitutional Educational Trust Ganset, commended the consultation on the Electoral Amendment Bill and said it should address many issues in order to make next year's election free and fair. He said delimitation of constituencies was a key area that government needed to look into. The problem we have is that delimitation has not been carried out for a considerable length of time and there was no delimitation after the 2012 census. If there is to be strict adherence to the constitution, the next delimitation will only be carried out after the next census is due. This would be an unduly long time since the last delimitation. It may well be that the current constituencies do not meet and may far exceed the numbers, he said. It is important to make provision for a delimitation exercise before the 2018 election to ensure that the constitution's requirements for the general equality of constituencies are met. The Zimbabwe Electoral Commission (ZEC) has in the past ruled out conducting a new delimitation of constituencies, saying it would conduct elections using the gazetted constituencies and wards. There was general consensus that the Electoral Amendment Bill should not be selective, but address the right to vote of prisoners, those living in the diaspora and people with disabilities. Mr. Wallace Mupfumua, a director from the Freedom to the Disabled Persons in Zimbabwe, said there was need to ensure that polling stations were accessible for people with disabilities. People with disabilities have a right to vote and that right can only be realized if they are able to access the polling stations, he said. ZEC should ensure that there is easy access to all polling stations and there are provisions for polling officers who can use same language should the need arise. The consultations will pave way for the alignment of the electoral bill with the new constitution.